Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. In this video, we're going to run through the memory items for a loss of braking event. Memory items such as this are something that we are regularly tested on in the simulators as part of our recurrency training. As the name suggests, they must be committed to memory due to the fast action that is required when these events occur. So we're currently inside the Fenix on approach to Luton's runway 25 with the simulator paused. I'll shortly take the simulator off pause and we'll run through a loss of braking event and the memory items for that on landing. I'd just like to run through those first. So the actions are, from memory, selection of reverse to max, so maximum reverse application. We will then release the brake pedals and we'd want to revert to the alternate braking system, and we do so by selecting the anti-skid and nose wheel steering switch to off. We then reapply brake pressure with the pedals, ensuring the needles on the alternate braking system indicator here should not exceed the one at the top of the green bars here on either side. Should we still not have brake pressure, still no braking, we would then use the park brake and we would apply that in short applications until we bring the aircraft to a stop, all the time with maximum reverse engaged. This procedure can be used at any stage of flight, so it could be takeoff, it could be landing, it could even be on the taxiway. The only caution obviously on the taxiway would be the use of maximum reverse thrust we need to pay attention to. Obviously ensuring that there is nobody around the aircraft and we are in the flight stage. So let's unpause the simulator and continue on down and run through those actions. Autopilot's coming off my control. That one.
I'm good. Minimum.
Continue. Reverse, spoilers, loss of braking. Reverse, max, brake pedals are released. We select the alternate system and we apply pressure, now not exceeding 1000 psi. We bring the aircraft to a stop. Once we're happy with the aircraft can stop, we can take the reverse thrust, use of reverse thrust out, and bring the aircraft to a stop on the runway. Obviously, should that process have not had provided braking, we'll then be using the park brake while moving in short applications. At this point, we'd probably want to consider getting towed off the runway. So to run through those items again, we select reverse to max. We release the brake pedals. We select the anti-skid and nose wheel steering system to off, which reverts the system to alternate brakes. We apply brake pressure with the pedals with care, not exceeding 1000 psi. And if required, if that was to be not effective, we'd use the park brake in short applications, bringing the aircraft to a stop and reducing reverse thrust than as required. Any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. Please hit the like button if you found that useful. Thanks for watching.